السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today I'm going to talk about the glasses of molecules or what is called cell wall defective bacteria. Molecules or what is called cell wall defective bacteria, and it is also known as cell wall free bacteria. Cell wall free bacteria. Firstly, I'm talk about the most important pathogenic species belong these glasses. Secondly, I'm turning your attention about the most important general characteristic of these glasses. And at the last, we discuss the disease caused by this bacteria. So, welcome you. Molecules, or what is called cell wall defective bacteria. Molecules, or what is called cell wall defective bacteria. This glass contain about 200 known species. This glass of molecules contain about 200 known species, but only 16 of them thought to be human origin. And there are 4 medically important species belong this genus. So out of 16 species belong the glasses of molecules, only 4 species can causes human disease. These 4 species included mycoplasma pneumoniae, which causes atypical pneumonia. Mycoplasma pneumonia, which causes atypical pneumonia, and it is also causes extra pulmonary stations, such as erythema multiforme, skin eruption, a type of hypersensitivity called erythema multiforme, and it is also causes osteoarticular manifestations such as Ritter syndrome or reactive arthritis. So the first species that have medically important in glass of molecules is Mycoplasma pneumoniae, which causes atypical pneumonia and extra pulmonary manifestations such as erythema multiforme and arthritis. The second species, Mycoplasma hominans. The first species belong this glass is Mycoplasma pneumoniae. Mycoplasma pneumoniae, which causes atypical pneumonia, and it is also implicated in extra pulmonary manifestations, such as erythema multiforme and arthritis. The second species belong this glass that also causes human disease is Mycoplasma hominans, which causes postpartum fever and also causes uterine tube infections. The third species called ureaplasma urealyticum. Ureaplasma ureolyticum. It is causes non-gonococcal urethritis. Non-gonococcal urethritis, and it is also associated with lung infection in a premature infant. So the third species that causes a human disease belong this class is ureaplasma ureolyticum. It is causes non-gonococcal urethritis and also causes lung infection in a premature infant. مثل ما تعرفون حضراتكم اكو عندنا gonococcal infection و non-gonococcal infection. Gonococcal infection caused by Neisseria gonorrhoeae. While non-gonococcal infections, many bacteria can cause non-gonococcal infection. One of them is ureaplasma ureolyticum, and also chlamydia species can cause non-gonococcal urethritis. The fourth species belong this class is called Mycoplasma genitalium. Mycoplasma genitalium. It is also causes non-gonococcal urethritis. So, in glass molecutus, which is cell wall defective bacteria, or cell wall free bacteria, four species can causes human disease. This species included Mycoplasma pneumoniae, Mycoplasma hominans, Ureaplasma ureolyticum, Mycoplasma genitalium. Put in your mind, Ureaplasma ureolyticum, sometime known as a T mycoplasma, T mycoplasma, because it is a produce tiny colony, very tiny colony when it is cultivated in a special media. So it is called T strain or T mycoplasma. So Ureaplasma ureolyticum, it is called T strain or T mycoplasma. Why? Because it is produced very tiny colony when it is cultivated on a special media. So this is four species that causes a human disease. Now, what is the most important general characteristic? What is the most important general characteristic of glasses molecutus? هاي الصفات تشترك بها كل هاي الأربع كل هاي الأربع سترينات. هاي الصفات تشترك بها المايكوبلازما نيمونيا، ureaplasma ureolyticum، مايكوبلازما جينيتيليام، مايكوبلازما هومينس. All glasses of molecutus are very small, very small. And the most important character, the most important character that found in this glass, as I said in the handout, is cell wall free bacteria. Cell wall free bacteria. That means this bacteria did not surrounded by cell wall. Absence of cell wall. هاي النقطة جدا مهمة. This glass molecutus, the main character of this glass is absence of cell wall. That means this cell not encased with cell wall. And as you know, cell wall is outermost structure of all prokaryote and eukaryotic cells, surrounded by all prokaryote and eukaryotic cell except Mycoplasma species, except Mycoplasma species. And as a result to this trait, to this character, as a result to this trait, other character found in this bacteria. That's mean as a result to absent to the cell wall. Other character follow this traits from that. This bacteria highly polymorph. ما عدها cell wall بالتالي هي highly polymorph. This bacteria did not stained by gram stain. Unstained by gram stain لأن ما عدها cell wall ونعرف مثل ما تعرفون الجرام ستين ويا من تداخل ويا الستركتشر الموجود بالسيل وول بالتيدو جلايكان and other structure found in cell wall بالتالي هاي البكتيريا ما عدها cell wall اذا ما راح تنصبغ بمن بالجرام ستين other character this bacteria resistant to penicillin and other derivatives such as cephalosporin اذا هاي البكتيريا ليش لانه البنسلين التارجت مالته شنو هو هو السيل وول انهبيت سيل وول سينثيسيس اذا البكتيريا ما عندها سيل وول اذا هي اولريدي ريزيستنت تو بنسلين اند ذير ديريفاتيف اذا هي ريزيستنت للبنسلين اذا نتيجه عدم وجود السيل وول ذيس بكتيريا تكون بليومورفيك resistance to penicillin and their derivatives such as cephalosporin unstained by gram stain unstained by gram stain other important character found in this glass or in species of mycoplasm is the presence of sterol cholesterol in their structure As you know, cholesterol or sterol is a unique molecule found only in eukaryotic cells. The prokaryotic cells, اللي من ضمنها البكتيريا, ما تحتوي على الاسترول أو الكوليسترول. Only glass molecules, species mycoplasma, contain cholesterol in their structure. Contain cholesterol in their structure. Other important character, this bacteria can be cultivated. This bacteria can be laboratory cultivated by using special and enrichment, special and enrichment media that contain complex nutrient requirement. When it is growth in special media, it gives an appearance called fried egg shape. إذن هاي البكتيريا المايكوبلازما ممكن عزلها مختبريا بسبيشال ميديا وراح نشوفها على شكل فد كاركتر اسمه فرايد ايج تشبه البيضة المقلية فرايد ايج So this is the general characteristic of glasses molecules. This is the general characteristic of glasses molecules. It is the smallest. The most important character found in this glass, it is cell wall free bacteria. Absence of cell wall. They do not encased with cell wall. And the second important character is the presence of sterol or cholesterol in their structure. Now, we are talk the first species in this glass, which is mycoplasma pneumonia, which causes a typical pneumonia, In addition to other general characteristic that I said in the handout, mycoplasma pneumonia contain terminal organelle. Terminal organelle, mycoplasma pneumonia contain terminal organelle, which is this terminal organelle, which is membrane-bound protrusion. This terminal organelle called membrane-associated proteins. Or cytoadhesion molecule. P1P13. إذن بالإضافة للأذر كاركتر اللي ذكرناها، المايكوبلازما نيمونيا contain polar organelle. هاي الترمينال أو البولر organelle تسمى membrane associated protein. Or cytoadhesion molecules, P1 and P13. This molecule used in the attachment or initiation of disease. So this molecule, I mean membrane-associated protein, used in the attachment or initiation of disease when it is bind to bronchial epithelium. This is molecule can be bind to specific receptor. Found in epithelial cells that lining or cover bronchial mucosa. When it is, put in your mind, this bacteria, it thrive in tissue rich with phospholipid. So the receptor or target tissue that bind with it contain salic acid rich glycolipid. هذا السالك أسيد rich glycolipid mainly found in bronchial epithelium. إذن terminal organelle اللي موجودة بالمايكوبلازما نيمونيا it is used for initiation, for attachment of this bacteria to specific structure rich with salic acid. This is a specific receptor that bound P1, P13 to initiate infections. Now, what the pathogenesis of this bacteria, Mycoplasma pneumonia transmitted by respiratory droplet. When this, now I talk about pathogenesis, it is important. When this bacteria attached to the salic acid rich glycolipid of epithelial cell, it is release a specific toxin. This toxin called card toxin, community associated respiratory dysitrous syndrome toxin. So when it is initiation the infection by bound to the target tissue, to the bronchial epithelium, by using P1P13 or terminal organelle, it is now release a specific toxin or a special toxin. This toxin called community associated respiratory dysitrous syndrome toxin. This is a special toxin called cartoxin released by Mycoplasma pneumoniae. pneumonia. This toxin interferes with ciliary actions of the ciliated epithelial cell found in bronchial epithelium. It is lead to what is called nuclear vacuolization and fragmentation of tracheal epithelium. As a result to this pathological changes, I mean destructions of ciliary bronchial epithelium, these cells cause this pathological changes causes destruction of a tracheal epithelial cell, which enhance local inflammatory response, lead to appear signs and symptoms of atypical pneumonia. So this is a pathogenesis of mycoplasma pneumonia, release of special toxin. This toxin interfere with ciliary actions of a bronchial epithelial, lead to vacuolization and fragmentation, nuclear vacuolization and fragmentation of epithelial cell that lining the bronchial mucosa, and as a result to this pathological changes, local inflammatory response will develop, lead to appear signs of symptom of atypical pneumonia. So mycoplasma pneumonia, it is most common causes of community acquired pneumonia and what is called atypical pneumonia. Why we call atypical pneumonia? What we mean by atypical pneumonia? The term used to describe pneumonia caused by organisms other than Streptococcus pneumonia. So atypical pneumonia, the term atypical pneumonia refers to pneumonia caused by organisms other than Streptococcus pneumonia. Atypical pneumonia can be caused by many organisms, bacteria and viruses. Bacteria such as Legionella pneumophila, Chlamydia pneumonia, Chlamydia bestiaci, and Coxsilla or Rickettsia burneyi. And viruses also can cause atypical pneumonia, such as influenza viruses and adenoviruses. So atypical pneumonia, this term used to describe pneumonia caused by organisms other than Streptococcus pneumonia. The most important character for this types of pneumonia, I mean atypical pneumonia, that all organisms caused atypical pneumonia cannot cultivated by ordinary media. يعني اللوجينيلا, الكلاميديا, الريكيتسيا والفيروسز, بالإضافة للمايكوبلازما, ما نقدر نعزلها مختبريا باستعمال البلد أجر أو التشوكليت أجر. يحتاج في special media to be isolated. هذا هي تسمى واحدة من الاختلافات عن الستربتوكوكس نيمونيا, اللي مثل ما تعرفون حضراتكم تنعزل بواسطة الأوردينري ميديا. هاي البكتيريا اللي تسبب الأتيبيكال نيمونيا. cannot cultivated by using ordinary media. In addition to that, clinical signs of atypical pneumonia included non-reproductive cough, absence of leukocytosis, بينما streptococcal pneumonia, or what is called loopar pneumonia, or loopar consolidations caused by streptococcus pneumonia, leukocytosis هناك موجود. هنا ما موجود leukocytosis. بالاتيبيكال نيمونيا نون ريبرودكتيف كاف، نون ريبرودكتيف كاف كونستيتيوشنال سيبتوم، يعني فلو لايك سيبتوم. الاتيبيكال نيمونيا، الاتيبيكال نيمونيا كان اولسو ريفير از ا ووكينج نيمونيا. من تسمع مصطلح الووكينج نيمونيا يقصدون اتيبيكال نيمونيا. ليش ووكينج نيمونيا؟ بيكوز از ان ماني كيسز، in many cases, in most cases, but not in all cases, in most cases the patient did not require admission to hospitals, because it this types of pneumonia can be resolved spontaneously, can be resolved spontaneously. He did not require hospitalization, so it is called walking pneumonia. In addition to that, this type of pneumonia restricted to small area of lung rather than involving whole lobes of lung as in other typical pneumonia. So a typical pneumonia restricted to small area of lung rather than involving whole lobes of the lung as in the loopar pneumonia caused by streptococcal pneumonia. Streptococcal pneumonia. واضحة هسه ليش نسميها atypical pneumonia؟ لأنه البكتيريا المسببة إلها uncultivated by ordinary media, uncultivated by ordinary media. وكذلك الكلينيكال ساينز مالتها، الكلينيكال ساينز مالتها تختلف عن الكلينيكال ساينز caused by pneumonia or streptococcal pneumonia. Streptococcal pneumonia. Now, what the laboratory diagnosis of this bacteria? Laboratory diagnosis of this bacteria, as I mentioned above, this bacteria culturable, but culturing did not recommended for ordinary diagnosis. لأنه يأخذ وقت هواي، يأخذ بحدود أسبوع إلى أسبوعين حتى تظهر، وبالتالي ما نعتمد على التشخيص، ما نعتمد على الكلتشر بالتشخيص، يعتمدون على السيروجيكال تيست. The most important and laboratory diagnosis of mycoplasma pneumonia or mycoplasma diseases caused by mycoplasma is serological test for detecting anti-mycoplasma IgM by ELISA technique, treatment of mycoplasma. تتوقعون اريد واحد يجاوبني لتريتمنت مال المايكوبلازما نيمونيا، لتريتمنت مال مايكوبلازما او اتيبيكال مايكوبلازما، تتوقعون البنسلين يستعمل؟ اريد واحد يجاوبني.
دكتور
احسن ما يستعمل. ليش؟ لان هي سيرو
ديفكتيف، ما عندها ببتيدوغلايكان.
ما عندها ببتيدوغلايكان، والبنسلين ما عندها سيل وول. البنسلين هو انترفير اون هيبيت اور انهيبيت سيل وول سينثيسيس. لهذا الدراج اوف تشويس ان تريتمنت اوف ا تيبيكال نيمونيا هو الماكروليد such as ازيثروميسين اند اريثروميسين. الازيثروميسين والدوكسيسايكلين هو الدراج اوف تشويس. الدراج اوف تشويس اوف كورس اذر فلوروكوينيلون therapy can be used for treatment of patients suffering from atypical pneumonia. This is picture show fried egg colony of mycoplasma pneumonia. Fried egg colony of mycoplasma pneumonia. So, I conclude the most important point in this lecture. This lecture about glass molecutus. This glass, it is also called cell wall defective bacteria, cell wall defective bacteria, or cell wall free bacteria. there are four medical species that causes human disease belong this class, which is a typical, which is Mycoplasma pneumoniae that causes a typical pneumonia, Mycoplasma pneumoniae that causes a typical pneumonia, Mycoplasma hominans, which causes postpartum fever, and Mycoplasma genitalium, which causes non-gonococcal urethritis, and urea plasma, urea lyticum, which causes also non-gonococcal urethritis, and also causes lung infections in a premature baby. The most important character of this class of molecules is absence of cell wall and the presence of sterol in their structure. And as a result to the absence of cell wall, many other characters follow this phenomenon, such as it is unstained by gram stain, resistant to penicillin, and highly bibliomorphic cells. A typical pneumonia, it is one of the most important or community-acquired pneumonia caused by Mycoplasma pneumoniae. This type of pneumonia can caused by other and many other organisms, including bacteria and viruses such as chlamydia species, in addition to mycoplasma or other viruses. Treatment, the drug of choice of a typical pneumonia is azithromycin and doxycycline. And if you have any questions, إذا أكو سؤال
إذا أكو جبار
عيني
يعني هم يسموها typical baseline measure بها cultivation لو مثلا على مود السيمتومز والهاي يعني
أيضا السيمتوم ذكرنا هي يسمونها typical بالإضافة أنه ما يصير بها cultivation السيمتوم مالتها non-reproductive cuff absence of leukocytosis بالإكس راي تختلف عن النيمونيا التيبيكال نيمونيا ماكو اللوبا كونسلتيشن اللي موجود بالاكس راي اللي نشوفه بال ستربتوكوكال نيمونيا ما موجود بالاتيبيكال نيمونيا هاي كلها بالاضافه الى ذلك هي did not required hospitalization and can be resolved spontaneously لهذا هي يسمونها اتيبيكال نيمونيا يعني clinical manifestation الاكس راي بالاضافه الى البكتيريولوجيكال اسبكتس نعم اكو سؤال بعد
واضح دكتور شكرا
جزيلا لكم اتمنى لكم التوفيق هاي في اخر محاولة.